رب العالمين. نحمدك يا رب حمد الشاكرين حتى ترضى. نحمدك بالإيمان ونحمدك بالإسلام ونحمدك أن جعلتنا من خير أمة أخرجت للناس من أمة خير الأنام سيدنا محمد. اللهم لك الحمد كله وبيدك الخير كله وإليك يرجع الأمر كله علانيته وسره. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن نبينا محمدًا عبد الله ورسوله، أدى الأمانة وبلغ الرسالة ونصح للأمة، فكشف الله به الغمة وجاهد في سبيل ربه حتى أتاه اليقين. اللهم جازه عنا خير ما جزيت به نبيا عن قومه ورسولا عن أمته. اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. ثم أما بعد. Indeed, we praise Allah and we seek His help and His forgiveness. We seek refuge in Allah from the sins of ourselves and from our wicked deeds. Whoever has been guided by Allah, there is no one can misguide, and whosoever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala allowed him to go astray, no one can get him back but Allah. And I bear witness that there is no one worthy of being worshipped but Allah and Muhammad, the Messenger of Allah. May Allah bestow His mercy upon His final Prophet Muhammad, His companions, His family, and all those who follow them till the Day of Judgment. Ameen ya Rabbil Alameen. My dear respected brothers of Islam, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Inshallah, to keep going, continuing, you know, talking about the same topic that we started maybe 2 weeks ago, that which one is more important, to be smart or to be self-disciplined? Which one is more important in this worldly life? And we proved, according to Al-Quran, the Book of Allah, and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, that to be self-disciplined, self-organized, actually, self-controlled, actually is more or beyond, better actually, more than to be smart. And your intelligence should guide you to follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to be committed. And we mentioned so many things last week, talking about that people actually always care about this worldly life and they pay less attention to the importance of working to the hereafter. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Quran, وَإِنَّ الدَّارَ الْآخِرَةَ لَهِيَ الْحَيَوَانِ لَوْ كَانُوا يَعْلَمُونَ. Indeed, the hereafter is the real life, not this worldly life. This is actually a temporary life. It is just, you know, very, very quick time we're going to spend here, and very soon we're going to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you can read this term in the Quran so many times. ثُمَّ رُدُّوا إِلَى اللَّهِ مَوْلَاهُمُ الْحَقِّ إِلَيْهِ تُرْجَعُونَ. You will go back, you will be returned back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means we start from there and we're gonna go back to there, inshallah. Today's topic, actually, we're gonna talk about the change that we should have in our life. في بعض الأحيان يدمن الناس عادات وتقاليد ويقيم الناس على مخالفات شرعية ربما تغضب الله سبحانه وتعالى ولا ينتبه الناس إلى أنهم يبتعدون كل يوم عن الله ولا ينتبه الناس إلى أنهم في كل يوم ربما يزدادون سوءا. We said that sometimes we keep doing the same things without paying attention if that thing gonna make Allah upset with me or displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or I'm doing for the sake of Allah. So we need to stop a little bit and be judgmental, but this time upon ourselves. Islamically, we cannot be judgmental upon anybody in the world. This is not your job. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only judge in this world. Your job is to be a servant of Allah, not to be a judge. But I can be a judgmental upon myself. And this is actually things or something was demanded by Islam. Islam told us you need to Be judge upon yourself. حاسبوا أنفسكم قبل أن تحاسبوا. وزينوا أعمالكم قبل أن توزن عليكم. Judge yourself before you will be judged. So if we're going to pay attention to the importance of the change which need to be done in our life, we need to ask ourselves why we need a change in our life and what happened in the past, in the history, that going to motivate us to have this change in our life, and which habits we need to give up and which habits we need to keep it in our life. We need to go back from the beginning of the history, beginning of the creation of Adam alayhi salam, because some people sometimes, especially when he is about to get married, what kind of ladies you are looking for, the first condition he gonna mention that I want someone who gonna accept me as I am. Who gonna accept me as I am? أريد من يتقبلني كما أنا. يعني أنا ليس عندي أي نية للتغيير حتى لو شهد الناس جميعا أنني على خطأ أو أنني إنسان في بعض الإعوجاج. أنا لست منتويا لأن أتغير. Some people said that clearly. I need somebody who gonna accept me as I am. I'm not gonna change. And this is actually something, if you think about it, not acceptable in Islam. If you're gonna go back from the beginning of the creation, when Allah had created Adam alayhi salam in the beginning, and because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that Iblis was amongst the righteous people at that time, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala exposed whatever in his heart to show him first that you are not qualified to be here. You cannot be in Jannah because you have a pride in your hearts. You are so proud and you cannot be here. So Allah proved to Iblis himself first. وَإِذْ قُلْنَا لِلْمَلَائِكَةِ اسْجُدُوا لِآدَمَ. Allah says, oh angels, and oh actually everybody here, prostrate to Adam, make sujood to Adam. Everyone responded positively to Allah except Iblis. فَسَجَدُوا إِلَّا Iblis. أَبَى وَاسْتَكْبَرَ وَكَانَ مِنَ الْكَافِرِينَ. He refused. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained what happened in different way. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قَالَ يَا إِبْلِيسُ مَا مَنَعَكَ أَن تَسْجُدَ لِمَا خَلَقُتُ بِيَدَيْ أَسْتَكْبَرْتَ أَمْ كُنْتَ مِنَ الْعَالِينَ. Why you didn't prostrate to what I made by my own hands? Adam, أَسْتَكْبَرْتَ, are you pride? Are you arrogant? That's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned what happened. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Iblis the full opportunity to repent and go back and correct himself. Now you have the chance to make the change in your life. But he refused. He refused to repent and have this change in his life. Subhanallah, if you look at the other side, Adam alayhi salam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us the best example ever in Adam alayhi salam. When he made this mistake and he disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, what happened? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says he felt the remorse or the regret in his heart. And then what happened? He asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive him. وَإِلَّا تَغْفِرْ لَنَا وَتَرْحَمْنَا لَنَكُونَنَّ مِنَ الْخَاسِرِينَ. Oh Allah, if you are not going to forgive us, we'll be losers. Will be the true losers, actually. From amongst those people who lost everything. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ فَتَابَ عَلَيْهِ إِنَّهُ هُوَ التَّوَّابُ الرَّحِيمُ. Adam was received the words from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which will not be given to anybody but the people who are seeking repentance. Adam wants to repent. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught him how to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The point here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْنَا اهْبِطُوا مِنْهَا جَمِيعًا بَعْضُكُمْ لِبَعْضٍ عَدُوٌ. Go, all of you, everybody, go out. بعضكم لبعض عدو. You're gonna be the enemies of one another. And Allah سبحانه وتعالى says something beautiful. Allah says, فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًى in Surah Al-Baqarah. فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًى. That means what? That means whenever you receive the guidance of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, فَمَنْ تَبِعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. Whoever gonna follow my guidance will never practice or experience grave or sadness or fear. خَوْفٌ عَلَيْهِمْ وَلَا هُمْ يَحْزَنُونَ. The other ayah in Surah Taha, what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in this surah, beautiful. قَالْ فَإِمَّا يَأْتِيَنَّكُمْ مِنِّي هُدًى فَمَنِ اتَّبَعَ هُدَايَ فَلَا يَضِلُّ وَلَا يَشْقَى. The meaning of the ayah, Allah will send this guidance, and whosoever will follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will never go astray and will never suffer any bad things in this worldly life. That means what? To be safe, you need to follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To survive, you need to follow the guidance. وَمَنْ أَعْرَضَ عَنْ ذِكْرِي. Whoever gonna turn his back to my remembrance, the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ. He will experience, he will face actually miserable life. He will have a miserable life in this worldly life. فَإِنَّ لَهُ مَعِيشَةً ضَنْكَ وَنَحْشُرُهُ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَعْمَى. And we resurrect him in the day of judgments as a blind person. Can you imagine? أَعْمَى. Let me stop a little bit here, because maybe we have some people who are blind, right, in this worldly life. When they listen to that, somebody will be resurrected in the day of judgment as a blind person, will say, what's wrong with being a blind? Allah never said, the Prophet ﷺ never said also, that the blind person in this worldly life will be resurrected as a blind person. Never. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala maybe will give him his sight back in the day of judgment. But when you face a lot of dangerous things, you know, very confusing things in this worldly life or any place in the world, you will appreciate the value of being, of you know, couldn't see. If you can see in the place, or you are walking in this certain place and it is full of dangerous things around you, so you will appreciate the value of being, of actually the ability of seeing things around you. But Allah says, in amongst the horrible things gonna happen the day of judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, we will resurrect him as a blind person. He cannot see anything around him in the day of judgment. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says also, he gonna wonder, قال ربي لما حشرتني أعمى وقد كنت بصيرا. Oh Allah, why you resurrect me as a blind person when I could see in this worldly life? He says, كذلك أتتك آياتنا فنسيتها وكذلك اليوم تنسى. So the reason Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent down this ayat in the Quran al-Kareem, not just that, also why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected this ayat, nobody can manipulate, nobody can change it. لا تبديل لكلمات الله. No one can change Allah's words. Why? To be the law, to be the constitution of all Muslims till the day of judgment. Think about that, and think about this ayat, and let us go back to the reality. Look at yourself, my dear respected brother and sister in Islam, and think, I need to be a judgmental upon myself. Nobody knows you more than yourself. You know about yourself what there are nobody else knows about you. Only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, because He's the whole wise, He covered you. لِحِكْمَةٍ سَتَرَكَ فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا. وَنَسْأَلُ اللَّهُ سُبْحَانَهُ وَتَعَالَى كَمَا سَتَرَنَا فِي هَذِهِ الدُّنْيَا أَنْ يَسْتُرَنَا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. We ask Allah, as He covered us, covered our mistakes in this worldly life, to cover us in the day of judgment. Ameen, Ya Rabbil Alameen. So, when you think about it, if you actually scan your life, yourself, your habits, how can I judge if this habit is good or bad? I need to have the curriculum, the constitution, the law, the rules. Then I'm gonna say, doing certain things or keep doing certain things in this worldly life is wrong. Why I'm saying this is wrong? Because Allah said, don't do it. And you're gonna go back to the Quran, to the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and you found anything in the Quran and Sunnah, say this is wrong. That means you need to give up. You need to break these habits. Otherwise, don't blame anyone but yourself. So some people are gonna say, actually, I'm lying a lot. I lie, I cheat, I backbite people. Okay, I'm actually watching pornography on the internet. Okay, or I'm masturbating sometimes. Okay, so is it right or wrong? You need to go back. Be honest with yourself. Nobody knows you as yourself. Go back to the book of Allah and the Sunnah of the Prophet ﷺ. Somebody smoking cigarettes, somebody smoking marijuana, weeds, somebody actually doing bad things. So many bad things. We're gonna talk about that today. Now we're gonna stand up in the front of the mirror and talk about ourselves. I'm talking about ourselves as community, as brother and sister in Islam. We cannot be judgmental upon anybody. I'm not judging anybody. I'm judging myself. I'm talking about myself. So when you need to talk about yourself. We need to judge. You need to judge yourself. And you need to change yourself. Why? Go back to the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and look at your habits that you are on right now. Is it right to keep going, doing it, or you need to stop and correct yourself and break these habits? توقف مع نفسك عند حدود الله سبحانه وتعالى لأن الله قال ومن يتعدى حدود الله فقد ظلم نفسه. Whoever gonna exceed the boundaries of Allah سبحانه وتعالى, he actually wronged himself. You did something against yourself, and you know yourself better than anybody else. You know what you're doing. So, first of all, you need to go back and define what is right and what is wrong. Not because everybody around you does what you are doing, it means it is good, it is okay. لو أجمع أهل الأرض على معصية أخذهم الله ولا يبالي. لو أن كل أهل الأرض أجمعوا على أن هذا العمل أوكي صحيح ما إيه المشكلة ما الناس كلها بتعمل كده كل الناس يفعلون ما أفعل ما المشكلة في ذلك لو أجمع الناس جميعا على مخالفة أمر الله لم يجعلوه صحيحا. People cannot make illegal things legal because they actually agreed upon. يعني لو أجمع الناس جميعا على ألا يتوقفوا في الستوب ساين. If people actually, everybody said, guys, we're gonna go outside, everybody in the masjid, okay? And you know the stop sign on the main streets? Don't stop. Everybody, don't stop. So actually, this is the cops, actually, happy day, actually. Okay, that's good. Nobody stop. Mashallah, tickets, tickets, tickets. Everybody gonna take a ticket, right? So we need to respect, first of all, the laws of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And if you define your mistakes, and you know this is wrong, I need to do something. There is some actually prerequisites need to be taken for the change. هناك شروط ومقدمات لابد أن تقدم بين يدي التغيير وإلا ما استطاع أحد أن يغير نفسه ولا أن يغير غيره في المستقبل. قبل كل شيء لابد أن نبدأ ونعلم أنه لا يمكن أبدا أن يتقبل شخص كما هو. قلنا من قليل عشان نبدأ التغيير. فكر قليلا. أريد أن يتقبلني الناس كما أنا. I want people to accept me as I am. I want to get married from of the lady, or the lady gonna say, I want to get married from the man who gonna accept me as I am. Imagine that Pharaoh in the day of judgment will come to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, oh Allah, you need to accept me as I am. Why Allah sent Musa alayhi salam? Okay? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the messengers to people? To accept them as they are? They came to change. To tell people, this is the way to change. I'm gonna help you out. Okay? So if
people practicing some mistakes or some kinds of disobedience, they need to stop and correct themselves. First of all, you need to admit that what I'm doing is wrong. And don't expect yourself, once you will say, I'm doing wrong things, I'm gonna start to change myself. Don't expect yourself gonna be successful from the beginning. You will fail so many times. You will actually go back to do the wrong things, but you need to start. To start, first of all, to say, I'm wrong, I need to give up. Some kinds of disobedience actually never been practiced unless it is with a group of people. يعني بعض المعاصي لا يمكن أن يتم إلا بمصاحبة بعض الناس وبعض المعاصي لا يتم إلا في الخلوات. Some kinds of disobedience you cannot do it unless you have certain people, this person or those people around me. And some kinds of disobedience actually habits, bad habits. Because when you disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and keep disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it became a habit. And the problem is the guilt is not anymore exists in your hearts. When I do something wrong, disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the beginning, I will feel that this is wrong. I feel guilty. Okay? But with time, when you keep repeating that, what's gonna happen? No more guilt in your hearts. You don't feel guilty anymore. And that's happened to every single person. So if you are lying, you are cheating, you're smoking, you're doing anything, you need to think about it. I need to change myself. I need to give up. Why? Because keeping going with these bad habits will make you a worse person, bad person. And Islam actually came to tell us, guys, you are not perfect. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't expect you to be perfect in Islam. Allah doesn't expect anybody to be perfect. But you need to keep trying. وَأَنْ لَيْسَ لِلْإِنسَانِ إِلَّا مَا سَعَى. Your job is to keep going, trying. Trying. لأن الله سبحانه وتعالى says, وَأَمَّا مَنْ خَافَ مَقَامَ رَبِّهِ وَنَهَى النَّفْسَ عَنِ الْهَوَى فَإِنَّ الْجَنَّةَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. So if you fear that the status of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and you prohibit yourself or you're gonna confront yourself and don't follow your desires, Allah will give you Jannah. The opposite, whoever gonna follow his desires, he will be put in the hellfire. فَإِنَّ الْجَحِيمَ هِيَ الْمَأْوَى. So where you want to be? You want to be in Jannah? You want to be in the hellfire? This is your choice. Choose for yourself and then don't blame anybody but yourself. أَقُولُ قَوْلِ هَذَا وَأَسْتَغْفِرُ اللَّهَ لِي وَلَكُمْ. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. We mentioned that if you're gonna change, you need to have some prerequisites. Some, يعني بعض الشروط لابد أن توفى حتى يتم التغيير. أول شرط هو النية. النية. The intention. النبي يقول إنما الأعمال بالنيات. Or بالنية, right? So your actions gonna be according to your intention. Okay? إنما الأعمال بالنيات. لماذا تغير؟ يعني بعض الناس ربما سيغير لأسباب دنيوية فتغييره سيكون مرتبطا بالأسباب التي غير من أجلها. والبعض الآخر يغير لوجه الله وتغييره يدوم ببقاء الله سبحانه وتعالى والله حي لا يموت. افهم ما أقوله جيدا. Some people will change some habits for certain reason, like a girl gonna get engaged. Then her fiance, okay, gonna tell her, I don't like that. In a second, everything will be changed. Like, you know, by the way, subhanAllah, a girl, she's beautiful, mashaAllah, and her parents kept telling her, actually, you need, actually, subhanAllah, to have this hijab. Now, mashaAllah, you grow up and you need to cover yourself and follow the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, I want to enjoy my life. I want to be beautiful the whole time. I'm not gonna wear a hijab. Because she has certain group of girls are the same. And actually they feed her these thoughts the whole time. I'm still young, when I grow up, when I became older, and then, subhanAllah, somebody came to propose, actually, her, engage her. She loved him. Second day, she got the hijab and put it on. What happened? He told me to put hijab. Really? Allah told you before, and you never respond to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The love. If we love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than anybody else, wallahi, we will listen to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala more than anybody else. This is intention. Why are you making that change in your life? If you're smoking something, you're watching something, why should I make that change in my life? Look at the consequences. What this habit's gonna take you to the hellfire? This is your choice. If you're gonna keep going. If you want to be in Jannah, you need to break these habits. You need to give up right now. Why? My intention is, wallahi, today, my intention was to talk about, subhanAllah, that certain, subhanAllah, kind of disobedience. But I'm gonna talk in general, and maybe inshallah next week, if you're gonna be here, if you're interested to listen to more details, you can come and listen. But subhanAllah, let us talk in general right now about the change. Subhanallah, look at the change when the change comes to your life. When you start to give up some kind of disobedience. When you break the habits because it is displeasing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. What gonna happen? I told you in the beginning, Islam doesn't expect you to be perfect. Even the people of taqwa, sometimes they're gonna make mistakes. But the difference between the people of taqwa, the people who have this self-consciousness, أهل التقوى لو وقعوا في المعصية ماذا قال عنهم رب العالمين والذين إذا فعلوا فاحشة أو ظلموا أنفسهم ماذا يفعلون قال ذكروا الله فاستغفروا لذنوبهم ومن يغفر الذنوب إلا الله ماذا لو لم يستغفر الله the people of taqwa the people who are what do you call it, like mindful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They are mindful of Allah, but their nature actually as human beings sometimes take over, sometimes disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, they does that. He's very good person, but the let. He subhanAllah, he did it. So if he kept doing it, it's gonna become a habit. So he's gonna pray, mashallah, and the sign of the prayer is gonna be here the whole time. Mashallah, he wore the jilbab like this one, maybe white, not this color. But he's gonna be always, mashallah, you know, in the front of people. Good person, but he practicing secretly some kinds of habits which displease Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and he doesn't feel any guilt anymore. Why? Because he didn't follow the guidance of Allah. Allah says, ذَكَرُوا فَاسْتَغْفَرُوا لِذُنُوبِهِمْ They remember Allah and they will ask Him to forgive them. وَمَنْ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ Listen, whoever forgive you but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, whoever has the authority for forgiveness but Allah. So you ask Him, وَلَمْ يُصِرُّوا عَلَى مَا فَعَلُوا وَهُمْ يَعْلَمُونَ They didn't insist, because insisting gonna make it a habit. And it's gonna be so difficult to give up in the future. Give up in the future gonna be somebody doing horrible things. And he never give up. What gonna happen? It became a habit. So what gonna happen? When he gonna stop himself, he will never be able to do that. Never. So look in the beginning. First of all, you need to have niyyah. Why I'm making the change? For the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Look at the consequences. The results, if you will keep disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or you're gonna keep practicing these kinds of habits. Look at the people who insisted, who didn't listen. What Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about them? Pharaoh, what happened to Pharaoh? I'm gonna tell you something. The people of Lut alayhi salam, what happened to them? You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a messenger of Allah to treat them. Not just to remind them, because those people were sick. The people who are homosexual, they are sick people. Actually, they isolate themselves. Some people can say, it is genes actually in the human being and it's something nobody controls. It is lies. It is lies. Because if you're going to say this is something actually come from inside the person, he cannot control that. How many things you think about, you cannot fulfill it in the worldly life. So yourself going to tell you not just to practice homosexuality, always going to tell you sometimes to go and kill somebody. Okay, kidnap somebody, rape somebody. So many things. Why this one you choose? And how it started? Don't think it started in general, in public. It started individually, secretly. And when people start to talk about it, okay, what happened? It became, subhanAllah, habit in the community. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَإِنَّكُمْ لَتَأْتُونَ الرِّجَالِ وَتَقُطَعُونَ السَّبِيلِ وَتَأْتُونَ فِي نَادِيكُمُ الْمُنْكَرِ. That means what? You are not shy to announce that we are gay. Yeah, everybody get what? That's what happened. And Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, وَمَا ظَهَرَتِ الْفَاحِشَةُ فِي قَوْمٍ حَتَّى أَعْلَنُوا بِهَا إِلَّا وَابْتَلَاهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي الْأَسْقَامِ الَّتِي لَمْ تَكُنْ فِي أَسْلَافِهِمْ. When people start to disobey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and make that publicly in the front of people and they are not shy to announce it, what's going to happen? Allah will take an action against those people. So this is like an example. If you think about it, sometimes people actually keep disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala secretly. And when he talked to another, wallahi brother, I smoking weed, marijuana the whole time and I cannot stop. Oh brother, really? Me too. Okay, what's gonna happen? Let's go and smoke marijuana together. Oh, I thought you're gonna tell me this is wrong. You need to stop, give up. No, actually let's. And third person, fourth person. So if I need to stop, what should I do? Look at yourself. Listen. إِذَا وَجَدْتَ الرَّجُلَ قَائِمًا عَلَى طَاعَةٍ فَعْلَمْ أَنَّ لَهُ عِنْدَهَا أَخَوَاتٍ فَعْلَمْ أَنَّ لَهَا عِنْدَهُ أَخَوَاتٍ. If somebody is doing something good, you should understand this is not the only good thing he's doing. He's doing so many good things, but you do not see. وَإِذَا رَأَيْتَ الرَّجُلَ قَائِمًا عَلَى مَعْصِيَةٍ فَعْلَمْ أَنَّ لَهُ أَوْ لَهَا عِنْدَهُ أَخَوَاتٍ. If he disobeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in public, oh, actually this is not the only thing wrong he's doing. This is not the only bad thing he does. He does so many bad things. Once you will start to repent and try to change, Allah will help you. You know, subhanAllah, they call it like a domino effect, right? You're going to just start the first piece. Push it. You're going to start with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you need to trust Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He will for sure will help you. Wallah, you need to take the action. Don't expect that Allah will guide you without asking for guidance. فَتَلَقَّى آدَمُ مِنْ رَبِّهِ كَلِمَاتٍ. Now, if you think about again, we have Adam and Iblis, right? They were both in the front of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They disobeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, committed different kind of disobedience, right? Think about them. If Allah chose Adam to be guided and to be repentant to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you will repent, but Iblis, you will be kicked out. Is that fair? No, it's not just. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just. So what happened? Allah offered them to repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Adam admitted his mistakes and he asked Allah for forgiveness. Allah taught him how to forgive, how to repent. Iblis, aba wastakbara wa kana min al-kafirin. This is the difference between both of them. So if you want to think about the Quran, wallahi, a lot of guys is the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala opened the gates of repentance to everybody. Everybody. Once you will start with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, add the subhanAllah, the domino. Domino subhanAllah effect. Push the first one and you will see how Allah will help you. Don't say, يعني subhanAllah, ادعي لي ربنا يهديني. Somebody is smoking, ادعي لي والله, inshallah ربنا يهديني. You need to start. Allah will never guide you guys. If you're lying, if you're cheating, if you're smoking, if you're doing any bad things, don't expect Allah will start His guidance without asking. You need to ask Allah. You need to take an action in your life. You need to do something in your life. Without asking Allah, Allah will never guide us. Allah will never guide us without asking for guidance. What are you going to say about Allah yahdi man yasha? Yes. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ يَهْدِيهِمْ رَبُّهُمْ بِإِيمَانِهِمْ وَالَّذِينَ اهْتَدَوْا زَادَهُمْ هُدًى وَآتَاهُمْ تَقْوَاهُمْ لِلَّذِينَ أَحْسَنُوا الْحُسْنَى وَزِيَادَةٌ قُلْ مَنْ كَانَ فِي الضَّلَالَةِ فَلْيَمْدُدْ لَهُ الرَّحْمَنُ مَدًّا. How many ayah in the Quran you need to listen to understand that we need to take an action against our bad habits? How many ayah you need to listen to? Wallahi, for the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they needed just one ayah. One ayah to break the habits. Addiction. Some people say this is, you need medical help actually sometimes because it is something actually in your blood and you cannot give up. What about the people who are addicted to wine, to drinking wine? You know, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in their houses, in their homes, they had a lot of wine. They were drinking wine the whole time. كانوا يشربون الخمر في كل الأوقات. وَكَانُوا يعني يَشْعُرُونَ بِبَعْضِ الذَّنْبِ. They felt some guilt in their hearts. I don't think this is right, but what I'm going to do? Everybody does it. Everybody does it. So they were drinking. عمر بن الخطاب يا رسول الله قل لنا في الخمر قولا فصلا. يعني افصل في أمر الخمر يا رسول الله. تنزل آية تلو الآية إلى أن يأتي الوقت الذي ينزل فيه رب العالمين يا أيها الذين آمنوا إنما الخمر والميسر والأنصاب والأزلام رجس من عمل الشيطان فاجتنبوه لعلكم تفلحون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was revealed ayat till Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, oh, you who believe, wine, okay, and gambling and the rest of the things from the deeds or from the actions of shaitan. Shaitan ordered you to do that. Shaitan يعدكم الفقر ويأمركم بالفحشاء والله يعدكم مغفرة منه وفضلا. A person voluntarily actually went through Medina, the roads of Medina, to tell people حرمت الخمر حرمت الخمر. He announced in the whole city of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam at that time that wine or drinking wine became forbidden. You cannot drink wine anymore. Imagine that. If the doctor said, you cannot actually eat more sugar, you're gonna do what? Okay, this is the prescription, and this is the medicine I got from the pharmacy. Now, this is the last piece of cake I'm gonna eat. Enjoy it, because I'm not gonna eat more sugar, no more carbs in my life, right? Don't drink wine. Okay, this is the last glass of wine. I'm gonna just... goodbye. They said, I'm not going to drink you anymore. Wallahi, what happened? According to the authentic sunnah, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كانوا قد صبوا الكؤوس فما رفعوها. They were ready to drink, and they never, subhanAllah, raised the cups or glasses to their mouths. SubhanAllah. Why? They start to spill or pour the wine in the streets. For days and days, you can smell the fragrance, or not the fragrance, the smell of the wine in the roads of Medina. كانت تشم رائحة الخمر لأيام في المدينة. صارت أنهار, it became like rivers in Medina. They give up. They give up. Why? Because they are listening to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If I'm going to tell you, you need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to help you. Have the intention, I'm doing something wrong, I need to stop. Why? Because actually it has affected my life, affected, subhanAllah, that my kid's life, my friend's life, everything, you know, was ruined by my habits. I need to give up. To break the habits, you need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and have the intention to change. And wallahi, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you for sure, 100%. We still have things to mention, inshallah. Next time, inshallah, if you have the chance, please come and listen to the rest of this khutbah, inshallah. نسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من الذين يستمعون القول فيتبعون أحسنه. اللهم آمن روعاتنا وأقل عثراتنا وبلغنا مما يرضيك آمالنا. اللهم ارحمنا رحمة واسعة تغننا بها عن رحمة من سواك. اشف مرضانا وارحم موتانا.
اجعل جمعنا هذا مرحوما واجعل تفرقنا من بعده معصوما ولا تجعل فينا ولا منا شقيا ولا محروما. اللهم احفظنا من بين أيدينا ومن خلفنا وعن أيماننا وعن شمائلنا ونعوذ بك يا رب أن نغتال من تحتنا. اللهم أعز الإسلام والمسلمين وانصر الإسلام والمسلمين في كل مكان وارفع راية التوحيد في كل مكان يا رب العالمين. وصل اللهم وسلم وبارك على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين.